Oké. Bluesmoes, kijkers en luisteraars, we zitten hier. We are here together with Roberto Morbioli en Stefan De Laporte of the Formazione Morblues, the Italiano. Or the Italian band Morblues. Thank you for the concert in Bluesmoes Cafe. How do you like it?
I like very much the place. It's not the first time for me here, you know. And the second time because I think 1 year ago I came here with Big Daddy Wilson and it was great, great evening, great concert. And this time with Morblues, with my band, I'm very happy to be here and I really enjoy it with the audience, with you guys. You do a lot of work, I know, and everything's perfect.
It is a special occasion because you have a new CD out. And maybe for our listeners, Morblues is a band who is almost 22 years in the running. Started in small town Italy and then went all over Europe. And this is your 10th or 9th CD?
Or maybe 11. Yeah, or maybe 12. I don't know. I don't remember.
I remember too.
Me too.
I don't remember.
Well, Stefano, maybe you remember, but you know, it doesn't matter. 11, 10, yeah, you know. But this CD is. I'm very happy about the sound, about the recording. I'm happy about the project, about how we work on it with the arrangement, with the band, with Stefano, Diego, and Daniele, and. I think it's very pure sound, you know, because this is live in the studio. I just overdubbed the vocal and some leaks, guitar leaks. That's it. That's
yeah.
Right, Stefano.
Yeah, yeah.
And Stefano, he worked also on arrangement, and we are very happy about the project, about the sound, because it captured the real Morblues sound, and this is it's important for the people. To hear the band, and you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Usually, you went to the studio, you do a lot of overdubs, and it's good. It's a different project, but you know when you play live, the people say, "Okay, this is a good song, but I miss something," because there is, background vocals, horn section, you know.
Yeah. It should be a CD. That means what you hear is what you get live.
That's right.
Yeah, I mean. During like the making of the CD, we work a lot of it on it, you know, just to, I mean, even like the CD was recorded like all together in the same room, just for having like the eye contact. Everything was like a live album, but it's a studio album, but with a live feeling, you know, and that's, I mean.
Like
that's how it makes
like
it makes
60s.
The CDs special, yeah. Yeah, like in the 60s.
Yeah.
Okay, what's more fun for you, creating a CD or playing live on stage?
Play live, of course. For me is I'm very afraid about when the studio and the recording, you know, because sometimes the label or. The situation, you need to record a new album, you know, for the people, because after 1 year, 2 years, they won't listen something new. And this is my stress, you know, it's for me, it's very stressful. It's like somebody push you in the, and then you say, no, I don't want to do it. But just because I went to the studio when I feel it to do it, you know, this is the best way. Like in the 60s, in the 50s, you know, they went in the studio, they have a budget, they went there for, a month, 2 months, 3 months, yeah, you know, a lot of money. It's true in Europe also, and then it relaxed. And then you have idea. You, but now economy is like you know is a little bit, especially in the blues scene. You know, it's very the budget. But our budget is there is no budget. You know, so but I prefer to play live because. This is the live band. It is we work a lot on the stage and on a live situation. So,
it proves that you're a live band because you also tour sometimes with special guests, like you did in the past with a few. Is that an extra? Is that a bonus? Can you learn from somebody who you played last? can remember live album from a few years ago.
Yeah, we have a couple of recording with two or three with the special guest.
The singer.
One is a big Jesse Johan from Baltimore. Okay. He's a black guy, and with him,
real blues voice.
It's a Sam Cooke, Otis Redding, and Bobby Bland together, and B.B. King. You know, it's very strange. He's got a very high tones and the bottom tone.
It's good for you because I heard some soul in the blues also. It's not only straight Chicago blues. It's much soul in what you're playing, and sometimes jazzy.
Yeah, you're right. And that it's good inspiration for when you have a people like Big Jesse, a guest like him, you learn a lot. Yeah. But sometimes, you know, it's just because it's the festival, they ask for a guest, and I don't want to do in anymore, you know, this cooperation, just because they ask. We want to work with the people because there is a reason why, you know. There is a project together, like with Justina Lee Brown, we have a project, we recorded an album together in the studio. And this is a project, this is different level, different...
You're more than a band to hire, correct, as backing band.
Correct.
There's more blues than just a backing band.
Correct.
Okay, I saw you had five guitars with you, Gibson and Fenders. Mm. If you have to choose one, which is going to be?
No, usually I don't bring a lot of guitar with me, but I force me to bring the guitar because it's good to, when you have a good guitar tone, you have to play, you know what I mean? And before, in the past, a couple of years ago, we play a lot in Italy, and so we have a chance to start, okay, this gig with this one, the other, but now you're on the road for a week, for 10 days, and you have to bring more, you know. And also I like to change the sound sometimes. Some song needs a different guitar. I don't like very much to do this, but I like to play this guitar, that guitar, because I have a special guitar, and you know what I mean?
I guess because I've seen you with Big Daddy Wilson, you're also good on an acoustic guitar.
Oh yeah, it's very good acoustic guitar, the Martin.
Another question, how is the blues scene in Italy? Because I don't have any idea how it is. Is it a good scene? And can you play lots in Italy? Or is it just in some regions and some don't? Tell us.
No. Italy is it's got a long tradition for the blues. But the last couple of years, the economy was bad in Italy, you know what I mean? And a lot of clubs quit with live music, and also the blues there now is a little bit out of the, you know, the people love to hear a different kind of music, you know, also the new generation, you know.
I think also that the youth should discover the blues somehow, and then it will survive, but that's the struggle it is now. The youth is now in electronic music, which isn't based on blues.
Oh yeah, but also, you know, that Stefano used to work in different situation, not only the blues scene, so he have idea more than me about what's happening, and he can talk about it.
Yeah, I mean, I think that at the end, everything like belongs to blues at the end. Somehow, like even like with like some weird electronic music or whatever, you find like some relationship with blues. It depends from like the knowledge of the people who is listening to it. But I mean, like as a musician, I mean you listen to everything and you try to relate everything to music at the end. It's, nothing is like belongs from kind of music, but it's just music. So, and blues is at the bottom for everything.
As I thought Willie Dixon said, no? The blues are the roots and the rest are the fruits.
You're right.
How came you in the blues? What triggered you to pick up a guitar? The ladies? No. The ladies are always the guitar player.
No. No, no. I started when I was very young to play guitar, and I started with to listen the rock and roll music before the blues. It's a little bit strange because a friend of mine lives across the street, and he's got a bunch of recording from his father, and you know, James Vincent, Eddie Cochran, you know, stuff like that, Carl Perkins. And then I start with the rock and roll, and then I discovered the blues from the rock and roll. It's not really good, but you know. And then when I was 14, 15, I discovered the blues, and I started listening to Muddy Waters, you know, John Lee Hooker, Willie Dixon, Jimmy Reed. And then for me, it's like, you know, it's like, I don't know, a big dream, you know. You say, oh my God, what is this music? Now I understand, because also Led Zeppelin, Deep Purple, you know, the rock music comes from the blues. So, and for me, it's a good inspiration to have a opportunity to listen to blues from different way, you know. And now when I play, I have a lot of rhythm, and you hear I'm more rhythm than the solo guitar player, you know.
I see it when you play.
No, my face, okay. We're talking about
the rhythm face.
The rhythm face and the feet.
Which is the best audience to play in Europe for, as you've seen it all? Seems to me the Germans, because they listen. They don't talk between the gig.
No, German, they're very quiet. Quiet. Okay, they listen. And they respect the music and everything, but I think there is no you know, the best audience, you know what I mean? Because I believe the people, it's your job to bring the people when you play. If the people talking or the people drink a beer and turn around and you know, it's because you don't play.
You don't do your job.
Yeah, or maybe you do the job, but not in the good way, you know? You know what I mean?
I understand probably.
I believe Europe is all Europe is good for blues. North Europe, you know, Netherlands, Belgium, Germany, France is good too for the blues, and England too, you know, Sweden.
How long can we still enjoy more blues?
Oh boy, I don't know. Now it's 22 years, so I hope a long time. But I don't know. I try. I do my best. But it's very difficult.
We do our best for you to play your song on the radio for us, and we make a nice show about what you did here in the States, and look it back on YouTube. Roberto, Stefano. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Until the next time.
Okay. And I want to say thank you to our agent Caroline, and I don't know. Ciao, Caroline. And Caroline, she worked a lot for more blues and for bring more blues here too.
Yeah, it's important to have a good agent.
She's very good. Not only in the job, but she take care of the band and everything, you know. And we are very lucky now.
You're lucky to have her. And she's better to watch than some ugly guy or old manager, let me say that.
Yeah.
Thank you very much again, and till next time.